I want you guys to do, you're going to have to do some cleanup on the outside, but the first muscle I want you to find is the levator scapulae. Okay. Levator scapulae, so there will be a bunch of actual pectoralis. Pectoralis is the most obnoxious of all cat muscle, and I end up just hacking away at it because you just, pectoralis in a cat is totally different and unrelated to pecs in humans, so I'm like, who the hell cares about them? And I just like go to town and just hack them off because it doesn't matter. But what will happen is if you look at, here's the spine of the scapula here, and there's going to be this muscle right here. Okay. This one is levator scapulae. And what you'll have to do is you'll have to take either your scalpel or scissors and kind of cut along, because there will be a patch of pec that is covering over the top of it. Okay. And it's about, like, it's the edge of it's about right there. So it's not very wide, like a finger wide. And you want to isolate this one first because it's the one that's most likely to get cut when you actually go to remove all the pectoralis. So we want to get that one first. And it's just a muscle running right there. So if I flip mine over, what I've done, I've actually already removed the pectoralis, but I've got my levator scapulae right there attached to the scapula. And its fibers are kind of running parallel to the arm like this, so you can kind of find its fibers that way. Okay, so that's the first one you want to get. You want to just get it isolated, okay? Then the next thing you want to do is get your latissimus dorsi. I think mine's dissected on both sides. Oh no, not quite. So latissimus dorsi is the big sheet on the side of the cat. You can just find the edge of it with your probe and then just pry it off. Okay, and it'll come off. And so when we look at this side, I've got my latissimus dorsi. I've got it still attached to the arm over here. Okay. So here's latissimus dorsi. And underneath of latissimus, there's this one that people think looks like a serrated edge of a knife. Okay. And that's, here we go. Okay. This one is serratus anterior. Okay. So it's just all jiggy jaggy. Okay. So this right here is serratus anterior. Okay. What's this one? Latissimus dorsi. Serratus anterior. Levator scapulae. Okay. Once you have latissimus pried up and you've got your levator scapulae separated, you can get your trapezius. Okay. So in a cat, trapezius is actually two separate pieces, but in humans it's one. So we like to keep it one piece when we get our cat. So on my cat you can see there's kind of a boundary right there. Okay. But we want to leave that intact. So what you're going to do is once you've found levator, then you'll also have the edge of your trapezius, and you can stick your finger and start prying it up from the scapulae, and you'll actually have to cut along the edge and just get it all the way free like that. So you actually will have to cut it free. It's not just going to come off. Okay? Especially right at this place where it's two muscles together, you'll have to cut underneath of it to get it off of the bone. Otherwise, the two pieces will separate, okay? Once we've got that piece and we've got our latissimus free, then we can see the muscles on the scapula. So here's the spine of the scapula. And do you remember what the fossa above the spine was? It was the supraspinous fossa. So this muscle is supraspinatus. Okay, supraspinatus. And the fossa below the spine? Infraspinous fossa. So this is infraspinatus. So we have supraspinatus above the spine, infraspinatus below the spine. Here's the spine right there. Then this little muscle down here, this is teres major. Cats don't have a teres minor that we can find, but we will find teres minor on a human. So if you're looking at the Kay Devlin sheet and you're like, oh, I guess we can cross off teres minor, you can't. Okay. So for now, just cats only have teres major. Okay. And then if we pull the scapulae away from the midline, so we pull it down, we've got a group of muscles in here. These are the rhomboids. Okay, so these guys, these muscles right here, these are rhomboids. Okay. There is a rhomboideus major and a rhomboideus minor, but you can't tell the difference in cats, and none of us can really tell the difference in the human. I think it's been shredded too much in the human to even tell. So we're just going to learn rhomboids. Okay. So we just got rhomboids. All right. And then what was the fossa underneath the scapula? Subscapularis. So there's a, subscapular fossa. The muscle is subscapularis. So there's a muscle underneath. You can see it in there. Subscapularis. It's like you guys are like paparazzi, like trying to get the best shot. I show it and everybody's like, okay. Subscapularis right there.
Yeah, that makes more sense.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So now for the pecs. To get everything else, we have to get the pecs out of the way. And there are two ways you can do it, and I feel like people had trouble both ways. I'm going to show you what I think is the easier way. Let me get my levator free here, and then that'll help us. This is annoying. You guys are right-handed. Suggest you dissect the right arm. Because cutting this way is terrible. Okay. So I've got my levator. Now, pectoralis will be covering over the top of part of levator, and then it'll also be laying on the arm like this. So once you've got it free of levator right here, you can find the edge of your pectoralis. And then what I would do is just start yanking it up. And you can yank it up, you can kind of cut it up a little bit. Okay. And at a certain point, you'll get, let me dissect this here. As you're pulling it up, you will get a piece of it that will be in between two of our bicep muscles, or two of the muscles that are part of the bicep group. So one, right here you can see how I've kind of got like some shredded muscle right there. This is where I actually had to take my scalpel and just cut straight across like this, because I was cutting pec free because it was stuck in there. And then once I got that bit of pec free, I just kept ripping at it. And if you pull it down far enough, then you'll see your biceps brachii. And once you see bicep brachii, it's right here, then you're good. And you can just leave this chunk on there. Okay? The other option, there will be one more little muscle right here that you'll have to get off to. And there'll be one muscle in the arm right here. It'll be like a thin little sheet muscle, and you can just cut it free also. It'll be nice and thin. As you're pulling this up, it'll try to come up also. And you want to make sure that you don't damage any of this vasculature here, because it'll be important. The other option is to just completely get rid of your pecs altogether. So all of this right here is pectoralis. And what I did is I just went up the midline, and I cut it free, and then I just yanked it all the way up and off. And then I still had to go and cut along here to get the piece free that was in between biceps brachii and this muscle here. But then it's the same result. The muscle was sitting right along here, and I just yanked it off. I think the easier way is to just do it from this side and peel down. But if you're like, I hate pecs, or you feel like chopping at big chunks of muscle because for whatever reason, then, you know, you can do it that way, too. Okay. So on the arm, we have, in the bicep region, we have biceps brachii here. It's more medial, bicep brachii. Then we have the chunk of pec that we cut out. That's not, okay. And then right next to it, we have brachialis. Okay. So this muscle right here is brachialis. Okay. And then we have another muscle that's running from the brachium down to the radius, and that's called brachioradialis. Brachioradialis is really easy to tear, so you have to be really careful when you're down in the elbow down here. But this one is brachioradialis. So what's this one here? It's brachialis. Biceps brachii. Brachioradialis. Levator scapulae. Right here. Above the spine. Supraspinatus. Supraspinatus. Here. Infraspinatus. This one. Teres major. Okay. Now for the triceps. This one right here, this is lateral head of the triceps. That's the last lateral head. The one right here, this is long head in the very back. And then over on this side, there's a division between them. It's not very big. Okay. But this is long head here. This is medial head right there. So it's kind of buried underneath all of this. So here's medial head right there. We have long head, we have medial head, and we have lateral head. Okay? Let me see if I forget anything. I think we got them all. I think that's it. Okay. Any questions? It's like difficult.